It's a bit noisy in the background, but I only have one thing to say in regards to this movie. Avengers Assemble!
What the fuck?
Hey guys, Psyco Culture's Anarchy here with another movie review for you on our road to civil war. And we have reached the halfway point. We have reached the culmination of 4 years of planning. The Avengers. Now, let's just rewind the clock a little bit up to Iron Man numero uno. The first Marvel Cinematic Universe movie that really, truly made this generation the best generation for comic book movies of all time. When we saw Nick Fury come up to Iron Man and tell him about the Avengers initiative, that set off this tension of waiting and waiting and waiting when the Avengers would assemble for the first time. And wouldn't you know it, after 4 years, 4 years of waiting, five movies, we got the Avengers. And by God, did they fucking blow us away. This movie is truly what it means to be a comic book movie, as it embraces all the comic book movie tropes. It embraces everything from the hilarious situations to the very conflicting different characters to clashes to fighting to just sheer all that shit, as well as that assemble shot that just makes every fucking comic book fanboy cry tears of joy. Just cry. Fond memories. But let's get back to the main thing. Let's talk about the Avengers in full spoiler detail. Now, we already know what the plot of the Avengers is. Loki, like in the very first ever issue of Avengers, has come to Earth and he has brought war down. He is ready to conquer the Earth. With the Tesseract and with the Chitauri, he plans on conquering the entire planet Earth for Thanos, but we don't know that yet. We'll get to that later on. But anywho, Loki, played by Tom Hiddleston, is just the fucking boss. And we start out with the whole Nick Fury arriving at that desert, in that S.H.I.E.L.D. desert, talking to Coulson, meeting Hawkeye. And even though this movie is beloved by all comic book fans have to agree that there's a lot to love about the Avengers. One of the main critics is easily noticeable. They kind of fucking wasted Hawkeye, like, you're a mind slave. You're just gonna be a mind slave for the entire movie. It's just like this scowl, like nothing phases me. Like this mask that you never see what's beneath whenever I'm talking about this shit. But anywho, that was only one of the probably the major critics with this movie, is just they kind of fucking underwhelmingly used Hawkeye. It's like, ugh. But we have a lot to love about this movie. We have a lot. Meeting the Avengers when they're in all of their separate parts, when they come in, seeing them meet for the first time, seeing them talk for the first time, seeing them in action for the first time, in the same screen. This is magic. This was magic. Because never before had so many people had seen that. Never before. X-Men was one thing, Fantastic Four blundered that, but this was the first time where we had actors who, most of them, have been in standalone movies, who have been leading roles, who have been Oscar nominees, who have done stupendous jobs in other roles, come together to create this magic, this once-in-a-lifetime magic. Because you can't beat the first time. You can never beat the first time. When the first time everybody saw the Avengers assemble, it was one of the greatest cinematic moments, period, because it officially confirmed that we are now in the Marvel Universe. We are in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. There was something, when I first saw it the first time back in 2012, people were on their feet applauding. They were like, oh my fucking God, this is amazing. Because never before have they seen something like this. And in all honesty, I really hate doing this because I'm a comic book fan. I love Marvel and DC, and I really hope to God that DC pulls it out of the bag with Justice League, because Batman vs. Superman was underwhelming, but seeing Batman and Wonder Woman and Superman fight together, fucking gold, but it honestly just doesn't compare to this one, because this is the first time that we get to see all these heroes together. Hulk, Iron Man, Captain America, Black Widow, Hawkeye. We see them come together. But anyways, I'm rambling on again because I'm getting excited because it's Avengers. But the main plot is simple. Loki has come down to Earth with the army of Chitauri. He wants to get the Tesseract for Thanos, who is collecting the Infinity Gauntlet, which we'll learn later on, like way later on, 3 years from now, 3 years from that point, and all that other shit. And Nick Fury realizes that this is a threat they cannot simply just fight off with maybe Captain America or Iron Man. He's like, no, it's time. We need to bring them together. And we see them all get brought together. Black Widow goes to recruit Hulk. Nick Coulson goes to get Iron Man. Fury himself goes to Captain America. He can't really do anything about Thor because, you know, he's up there in Asgard and all that shit. But regardless. And then they start coming together. And one of the best parts is when Thor and Iron Man meet for the first time, they fight right away. They, like, it is fight night. That is how it happens. They're beating the shit out of each other. There's so many awesome moments. They are pounding each other. And then you see the next awesome shot. You see Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor all standing together. And they're just, I'm just like, this really can't get any more awesome. And then we see, like, I love, this is what Joss Whedon truly excels at. I love seeing each character get a moment, a funny moment, a serious moment, a tense, every kind of moment, where we see Steve Rogers contemplating, like, each movie, all these characters, they get advanced in this movie. That's the magic of Joss Whedon. He made each character, like, advance their personalities, their characteristics, everything. Thor, still holding remorse over Loki, and, like, how he's just like, I really hate how because of me, that he feels guilty because he didn't really truly love his brother as he thought he should have. And then there's also Captain America, who's like, I'm not in from this timeline. I'm dealing with these egotistical new guys and all that shit. And Tony Stark is, you could see that some of the things Captain America says, that you are not a hero. Like, you're not a threat, but you're not a hero. That it kind of hits him, because he's just like, even though Tony became Iron Man for the sake of, like, you know, righting his wrongs, he still does it in his whole Tony Stark flair. He's an egotist, like, it's all about me, ha, I'm Iron Man, Tony Stark, everything revolves around me. And then he meets this guy who's like, it's not always about you, this is about everybody else. He's like there's not always a way out, sometimes you gotta take the bullet. And it, like, that's the awesomeness about it, just seeing that these guys, they don't always get around. In the modern world, these guys aren't all buddy-buddy, ha-ha, we're all pals and shit. No, they will fight. They will clash. Their mindsets, their ideologies, like instantly, the seeds of civil war have already been planted. And we've been culminating this for 4 years, but it started all the way back in Avengers. When Tony and Cap's ideas were already clashing. Their own ways of doing things. But after a while, Loki is manipulating everybody and all that shit. He is smart. I love the scenes with Black Widow and Loki where he really gets in her head, but then she reverses that and then she realizes, oh crap, he's gonna unleash the Hulk. And Mark Ruffalo as the Hulk is just unfucking believable, because I love where he instantly, the moment Black Widow's like maybe you should get out of here, and he's just like, really? Who's the one who bought me here? Who's the one who recruited me? You guys did. You guys put everybody at risk. It's your own fault that I'm here. I didn't want to be here, but you dragged me here. And all that stuff, the chemistry, the banter, it's what makes this movie so naturally cohesive. You cannot have a movie without good banter, smooth transitions, good characters. You gotta make sure the movie is cohesive, because you're juggling 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different big, larger-than-life characters, and Joss Whedon does it beautifully. And that's what I love about this movie. And I see, and then when things are going to shit, brainwashed Hawkeye starts attacking the helicarrier, you see them starting to work together. Tony and Steve, in particular, really just show, like, instantly working together perfectly. And then Coulson dies. Because of their bickering, because of their ignorance, because of their lack of faith in one another, a good man died, and then they realized that, and then they know. And Tony's epic speech, we're the Avengers, Earth's Mightiest Heroes type thing, And when they come together, when they are getting to New York, they're all coming together. Hulk, with the Hulk was a spectacle, without a doubt. Hulk was a fucking spectacle to watch. When he morphed, when he hulked out for the first time, punching that fucking Leviathan Chitauri right in the face, and all that shit. And then we get the fucking assembly shot and all that crap. And then we get Cap just fucking listing off things like, okay, you do this, you do this, you do that, all that shit. I absolutely love it. And then there's also this just beautiful 1 minute shot of just pure awesome. That made me just want to scream in joy, and I did, because it's just, I really cannot describe how amazing this movie is. Not just because I'm a fucking geek and I'm a loser like that who just will praise Avengers to no end till the very day I die, just like how I'll praise The Dark Knight, how I'll praise Man of Steel, how I'll praise Guardians of the Galaxy, how I'll praise most very, very good, exceptional comic book movies till the day I die. This movie is just special in that regard, because Loki was a fantastic villain. The Avengers coming together, first in conflict and then as a team, is just one of the best things about this movie. It just shows that they picked the right guy to fucking do this. I loved the after credit scenes with them eating shawarma together, and I also love the whole Thanos is coming, there's a much bigger threat coming. So, guys, there's really not much else left to be said, except for the fact that this movie, The Avengers, is without a doubt one of the best comic book movies of all time, period. Because this movie truly brought the magic to life when we saw all of our favorite heroes that we've watched from 2008 to 2012 come together to form Earth's Mightiest Heroes. So guys, I'm going to give this movie a 10 out of 10 because this movie means the world to me. This is what I love about comic book movies, about Marvel, about DC, Image, Dark Horse. This movie exemplifies what it means to be a comic book fan, a movie fan. And for that, I'm always going to give it a 10 out of 10. So guys, this is Psycho Culture's Anarchy signing off. Like, comment, and subscribe, because I'm going to do this regardless. I don't care why, I just want to. And so all you psychotics out there, you stay crazy. And when I call for it, assemble!